What up, everybody? It's your boy Gaming Forte back at it with another video. Make sure you hit that like button, make sure you hit that subscribe button, make sure you do all of those things along with the notification bell so you can know the next time one of my videos go live. Now, Sony has finally announced the Spider-Man PS4 bundle. And not only did they announce one bundle, they announced two bundles. One is a PS4 Pro, one is a standard PS4 Slim. 1 terabyte in both of them. They pretty much have the same exact art style on the system. So what do I think about this? Let's dive into it. So before we get into this conversation, let me tell you that these are my thoughts and my feelings. I know a lot of people are probably not going to agree with me on it, but the end result is I believe these are some of the best looking systems that Sony has ever made for the PS4. I believe the God of War system was actually a really nice looking system. I know a lot of people don't agree with me on that, but I do know once I seen the system up close and personal, I was like, it's okay. It's just, you know, you really don't even know what that system is unless somebody told you exactly what the design on the system was for God of War. But for this system here, this PS4 limited edition Spider-Man system, this looks clean as hell. Now, I am a person that was expecting a little bit more from Sony on this system. I think it was the fact that I was more of a prisoner of the moment of some of the fan art I saw of some systems. I know a lot of people been seeing the one that had, like, it looks like his suit is overlaid on top of the system with the red and blue type controller, which I have on the screen right now. But I think I was expecting something like this and not just a solid red system with the emblem on top of it. And don't get me wrong, this system looks amazing. And I know a lot of people are going to really enjoy buying the system and having it in their entertainment system. But for me, I was just expecting more. But this isn't going to change the fact that I'm still on the fence about picking up this system. I had to actually come home, think about it. I talked to one of my good friends, you know, shout out to her. And, you know, she even said the same thing, that the system looks great. And I told her how I felt about it. But the biggest thing that I just want to do is make sure when I give you guys this information that it's from a place of non-bias. Like I said, I was expecting more, but if this is a system that you think you want to have, you should go out and get it. Because this system, like I said earlier, is by far the best one that they actually made. And not only do you get the system, you also get that very nice red controller, which looks amazing because I really like the white button prompts that that red controller has. It really stands out when you actually have it right next to the system. And I really do hope that they sell this controller separately. I know they did that for a couple of their systems in the past. They did it for the Star Wars Vader bundle. You can get that controller separately in different areas. I never ended up getting one, but this will be a nice centerpiece to actually have right next to your system. And if you can get multiples of them, that would be cool too. But now let's get into a little bit of the specs that the PS4 Pro will have. They did release what you will actually see in the game when you pick up Spider-Man and what those visual differences are going to be on a PS4 Pro with a 4K TV. So this is what they had to say. On a PS4 Pro, 4K TV owners can experience Marvel Spider-Man in 2160p dynamic 4K resolution, achieved through temporal ejection that showcase intricate details of the architect of Marvel New York City and details of the Marvel characters. HDTV owners will benefit from game's built-in super sampling, which increased the image clarity and details. Meanwhile, if your TV supports high dynamic range HDR, you'll experience vibrant special effects like Mr. Negative's negative powers and brilliant lighting across a picturesque Manhattan city. So this is great news overall. I know a lot of people are going to be super excited to get their hands on this limited edition system. Even knowing I am a little disappointed in the system, I'm still thinking about picking it up just because it's not a bad looking system. It's just not exactly what I was expecting it to be. But ultimately, it's really going to come down to you and your decision making process. Me personally, I already have a PS4 Pro. This system had to be head and heels better looking than the one that I have, which anything would look better than a regular black system like I have now. But I'm just trying to weigh the options of trading my system in for like $200 to $250 and only paying $150 for this version of the system. Maybe I'll do it, but I gotta make a decision real fast on it. I think it's like $50 to put it down on GameStop, so you can actually just pay on it as you go and then trade my system when this one does come out. So I will keep you guys posted on what I decide to do with this Spider-Man system, if I try to get it or not. And plus, I am getting that collector's edition for Spider-Man, so that's gonna be a bit of change that I'm gonna spend on September 7th when this game does release. So that's gonna be cool. Man, where all my money gonna come from to buy all these games and all these systems? Gotta just start saving up now, I guess. But hey, if you're a person that can't afford $399 for this version of the system, guess what? Sony's got your back. They are actually bringing out a 1 terabyte slim version of the same exact console. Same skin, or should I say same, you know, decorations with the spider logo right on top of it. Same controller, and that system's gonna be $299. Now I can see that system dropping down as low as $349 if they have some available during the holiday season, which I probably doubt they will, because these will probably be gone by the end of September. You won't find these anywhere. And this does come with, like I said, the one controller of the system, does come with a copy of the game and everything. And I'm honestly shocked that Sony is doing the same bundle on both systems, because with the Days of Play PS4 that came out, which I thought was a very nice looking system, they did a standard PS4 Slim, but they didn't do a Pro. Same thing with God of War, one of their own IPs, one of their biggest IPs that they had that came out this year, they only did a Pro. They didn't do a standard PS4 Slim. So the fact that they're putting all their backing behind this Spider-Man game, and they're saying, hey, not only are we gonna do this Pro bundle, we're gonna do the same exact system, the same exact way, but we're gonna do it in a slim factor with our PS4 Slim 1 terabyte. So Sony is swinging for the fences with Spider-Man. I think this game is gonna sell super well. I think it's gonna be somewhere in the high 80s, maybe, with Metacritic. Maybe like 85, I can see it being somewhere in that ballpark range. The game does have a lot of competition during that month. You have Destiny 2 Forsaken DLC coming out on the 4th. You also have the new Tomb Raider coming out, I believe, on the 12th of September. You have Spyro coming out, and I don't think Spyro is going to really do anything against this game. So I really think that it doesn't have its work cut out for it, because I think Spider-Man is just that big of a franchise. Marvel is on an all-time high right now, and Sony is going to really capitalize on that. You're going to see marketing everywhere for this game. You're going to turn on your favorite TV show and you're going to see this logo everywhere with this system plastered on everybody's TV. Now, I think they're going to promote the PS4 Pro more than they do the Slim, because they do want people to play Spider-Man at the intended resolution that the developers decided that they want that to be, which is, you know, 4K upscale, you know, checkerboard and temporal injection, whatever they're doing with their version of the game. And I still think people are going to go out and buy the PS4 Slim, because that is the highest selling system right now. So this is definitely something that we need to pay attention to through the month of September and October and November, because I think Spider-Man is going to be one of those games that might not only sell 5 million, it could pass 10 million, but it also could sit in that 6 to 7 million range. It really just depends on how many people want to play this game and what the hype is going to be in the first 24 to 48 hours. If this game sells 3, 4 million in the first 48 hours, like God of War did with its 3 million in the first, I believe, 24 to 48 hours, or it might have been the first week, then this game's going to sell well over 10. This game can also rival games like Rockstar's Red Dead Redemption at the end of the year, but you never know. But ultimately, guys, this is a good looking system. Go out and get it if you want it. I am definitely thinking about it, and I will update you guys on Twitter if I do decide to do it. I'll just take a nice little screenshot of my receipt saying, hey, it's done. So guys, what do you think about the system? Is it something you're super interested in? And if you don't have a PS4 or a PS4 Pro, is this going to be the game and the system that is going to make you pick up that system? I definitely want to hear what you guys got to say in the comment section. And before I go, there's also other bundles that are available in different countries. And now that I think about it, the PS4 Slim, as of right now, is only available in Europe, I believe, not available in the US, which kind of sucks. So guys, I'm actually looking at the article right now, and it does look like Europe is getting the second system. It's going to be a PS4 Slim 1 terabyte system. It's going to mirror the PS4 Pro, and it's going to be only available in Europe as of right now. And if that wasn't enough, Europe will also get a bundle with a standard black 1 terabyte console that comes with the game, and it will also have a black PS4 Pro bundle that comes with a copy of the game with a 1 terabyte hard drive, and it also comes with a controller. And then the PS4 Slim, they're also going to have a black version of that system, which comes with 2 controllers, and that's only available in Germany, Australia, Switzerland, and Italy. And finally, they will have a variant of the 500 gig jet black PS4 only for Germany, Australia, Switzerland, and the UK, and a copy of the game will come with that too. So man, as of right now, North America is only getting the Pro. Hopefully they do change that information around, because hey, a lot of people would just rather pay the $299 and get the base PS4 1 terabyte version of the system, because like I said, it does look good, and for $299, that's a steal, and it comes with the game. So Sony definitely needs to step up and have this console come out in all territories on the same day. People that are interested in this system aren't going to wait for it to come down the road, because you need to strike while the iron is hot. And me personally, if I didn't have a PS4, I would probably go with that standard PS4 1 terabyte Slim, because it looks just as good as the Pro. You just don't get the benefits of the Pro, and some people don't have the extra $100 to throw down on it. So make that readily available for everybody, Sony. But guys, thanks for watching this video. Sub to the channel if you haven't. Like this video if you like the content. It definitely helps out that channel a lot. Turn on your notifications. Gonna let you know the next time one of my videos go live. It's your boy Gaming Forte. You guys have a great week, and I'm gonna talk to you in the next video. Peace.